Good morning, students. My name is Hardeep Singh and I am your science teacher. Today we are going to start our new session. Hope you all are fine. Now we are going to start the syllabus of April month. That is first chapter. Name is Sources of Food. That means food, you all know what is food. And what are its sources? Means from where we are getting the food. That are its sources. First topic is food and nutrients. First of all, we will make a basic reading. Then we will come on to the explanation part. I'm just reading for it you. What will happen to a car if it runs out of petrol? Its engine will stop. Petrol is the fuel that burns in the car engine and supplies it with energy. Similarly, your body also needs fuel to keep it working. The fuel you use is called food. In first paragraph, they are just comparing ourselves with the engine of a car. That means we need petrol to run the car engine. And that petrol supplies the energy. But similarly, our body, it also needs fuel so that we should keep on working. And that fuel is food. We usually take it in the morning also and night also. Further, to keep a car engine running properly, it should be supplied with the right amount of fuel and oxygen. Without a proper balance of these two substances, the engine will not run smoothly and may even stop. They are just saying, when they are comparing the case of a car engine, it should not only need the fuel, oxygen must be there so that fuel burns in the presence of oxygen. When these two substances are available, the engine runs smoothly and it will not stop. In the same way, to keep your body working properly, it must be supplied with the right amount of food chemicals. That means if you want to work properly, the food has some substances, has some chemicals in it. These chemicals are known as the nutrients, and these nutrients are needed by our body. So second concept, that is what is the functions of food. Food has mainly three functions according to your book. Provides energy, and we need energy to do various activities, that like in the daytime we use running, we use singing. These are all the activities. Like when we eat the food, after that we do the digestion. Means digestion start in our stomach. It is also activity, and for that energy is needed. And food also helps body to grow. That means food provide essential things, essential nutrients, which helps the cells to grow. Third concept is it protects the body from various diseases and keep it fit and healthy. Like in today, in these days, doctors are saying take a high protein diet so that your immune system gets better. So from this point, we are well aware that food helps us to fight with the diseases or protect us from various diseases and keep us fit and healthy. So this is a concept of functions of food. We are again reviewing this. The first is providing energy to carry activities. Second is help the body to grow. And if body is growing, that means cells are growing. Third concept is it protecting the body from various diseases. And if we are protected from the diseases, we will be healthy. So these are the functions of food. Next is variety of foods in India. That means different kinds of foods. Suppose in Punjab, we are getting different kinds of food. And in Tamil Nadu, we are getting a different variety of food. And in Nepal, we are getting a different variety of food. Like in Tamil Nadu, they are just eating idli and dosa. But in Punjab, the makki, the roti, and saro da saag is very famous. So we will be comparing the variety of foods in India. I'm just reading first for you, then we will go on with the explanation part. India is a vast country with different type of soil and climate, which determine the crops, vegetables, and fruits that grow best in a place. People in different regions of India cook differently. That this paragraph is giving us information that different areas have different types of soil, and different types of soil support the different crops, different vegetables, different fruits. So in different areas, people are getting different type of food, so they are cooking different type of food in different areas. These factors mean that food culture is various regions of the country is different. As I have already told you, whatever food we are getting in Punjab, the same food we are not getting in Tamil Nadu. And in Tamil Nadu, we are getting different amount of food. Here, there is an activity number one, collecting and analyzing information. That means, suppose some of your friends or some of your cousins, they are from the different state. We can make a call to them. We can ask what type of foods they are getting in their state and what kind of. And similarly, you can also tell to him that this kind of fruits or vegetables we are getting in Punjab. So we can make a comparative study. This activity is based on that. Next is the ingredients of food, means what is present in food. First of all, we are reading, then we will come on to the explanation part. A basic food dish such as boiled rice is made by boiling rice in water. This food has only two ingredients, rice and water. Chicken biryani, however, is made of rice, water, chicken, salt, several spices, and vegetable oil. It has several ingredients. Where do we get these ingredients from? We get them mainly from plants and animals. However, water and salt are the two ingredients obtained from the earth. So this is a basic idea of ingredients. Suppose you are cooking some kind of dish. Example, it's a boiled rice. And when you are boiling a rice, you have two things. One is rice and one is water. These two are the ingredients that are present in a dish that is named as boiled rice. Suppose you are cooking a chicken biryani, you will need more ingredients. One is rice, one is water, chicken, salt, spices, means masalas, vegetable oil, like we are using a refined oil in our house. So this chicken biryani has one or more than one type of ingredients like rice, water, chicken, salt, spices, vegetable oil. Some of the ingredients we are getting from the plants and animals, and some of the ingredients we are getting from the earth, like water and salt we are getting from the earth. But the other ingredients we are getting from the plant and animals. So this part is also done. Now we are moving on to this activity number two, that is collecting information to find out the ingredients and sources of your food. Suppose you, this is example of a boiled rice and this is example of chicken biryani. You can compare third more, you can compare like you have means your mom has prepared something like gulab jamun. But you have to find, this is your task, you have to find what are the ingredients to prepare the gulab jamun. So many things you can include according to your common sense. Theek hai? Next is the sources. Our topic is sources of food, and same our lesson name is sources of food. We know that we are getting food from plants, also animals. How we are getting the food from plants, like cabbage, onion, that is the plant food. Like we are getting the eggs from hen, that is the animal food. So we can say we are getting the food from plants and animals. You know that green plants prepare their own food from non-living things, carbon dioxide, water, and sunlight found in the environment. Green plants are known as producers. You are well aware of the process photosynthesis, in which plants are preparing their own food with the help of carbon dioxide, water, and sunlight. So the plants are preparing their own food, so that's why they are known as the producers. They are known as the producers. They prepare extra food also, and that extra food is eaten by the animals also, and it also stores that extra food. So we are getting the different food from animals. You can use your own common sense way. What kind of foods we are getting from the animals? Like, we are getting milk from cow and buffalo in your houses. There are cows and buffaloes available. You are getting milk from them. Eggs we are getting from hen. Meat we are getting from hen. And this is a concept of honey. Honeybee, we are getting the honey from the honeybees. So this is a concept. This is a experiment 3, experimental investigational, to sprout some seeds. You can take the moong dal, place it in water, then take it out of the water, place it in a cloth, tied the cloth, wet the cloth, leave it for 2 or 3 days. You will see your seeds will get sprouted. That means seeds will start germinating. Like, this kind of structure will start coming out of the seeds. You can try this thing in also at home. And one last diagram we are going to discuss. That means this is a food we are getting from, means plants, like fruits we are getting from plants, like these kind of fruits. There are so many fruits, you can also include that fruits. And so many means leaves we are getting from the plants also, like a cabbage. We are using this coriander, pudina, and potato, sugarcane, ginger, radish, turnip, carrot. These are the well aware terms that we are using daily in our wheat, pea, rice, cauliflower, broccoli,